Alrighty folks, what is up? My name is Melvin and welcome back. So the GTA Definitive Edition has been out for a few days and it's a load of garbage, just from what I've seen. And at first I was excited for this Definitive Edition, not for any reason in particular, only because these three GTA games have finally been released on a Nintendo platform, so I could recommend this game to friends who've only had Nintendo systems growing up. Yeah, one of the biggest companies of all time has made one of the worst remasters I've ever seen. I absolutely love each of the games, GTA 3, Vice City, and San Andreas. I've actually played quite a few of them on the iPad edition. I know the San Andreas one has controller support. I played GTA 3 just on my iPad, so and Vice City as well. The graphical fidelity is not worth it. The character designs still look like garbage and in some cases look worse. Some of the soundtrack is taken away from what I've heard, and again, this is no excuse from a company that has made billions of dollars from selling video games. When you're dealing with a trilogy this amazing, you really have to take your time. These are some of the best open worlds in just any game. It's very vivid. There's a lot of memorable locations and things to do, and not to mention that the cheat codes are just so much fun. And to just not have the cheat codes, it's 1/4 of the masterpiece you should be getting from the original. Honestly, there should be no compromises, but it seems like there was a ton of them and you're paying $60 for them. The execution is one of the worst I've ever seen, and it shows that why game preservation is actually more important than ever, because these big corporations don't care. The only people that really do care at the end of the day are people like us, people who grew up with the game, are very nostalgic over it, keep copies of it, keep multiple copies of it. They don't want to sell you the ones that are much, much cheaper, have cheat codes and things like that where you can mod the games. They really don't want that anymore. They really just want what makes the most money. And what makes the most money are the most up-to-date games, the ones that just got released yesterday, not the ones that got released 10 years ago, 15 years ago, or even 20 years ago. That, to them, they don't care. That doesn't make them the same kind of money.